Good evening, everyone, and welcome to night two of our Holy Week experience. Tonight, I will be discussing the events that took place on the Wednesday leading up to our Lord and Savior's death. Holy Wednesday is the fourth day of the Holy Week and the day where Christians remember the day that Jesus was betrayed by Judas. It is the Wednesday before Easter and the last week of Lent in the West. On this day, the Sanhedrin gathered and plotted to kill Jesus before the Feast of Pesach. It can also be called Spy Wednesday because it is the Wednesday before the crucifixion that Judas conspired to hand over Jesus. He was only given 30 pieces of silver to betray our Savior. This isn't what I really want to focus on for this Wednesday. I really want to focus on what was taking place before this plot, and that was the preparation for Jesus' burial. All four Gospels present an account of Jesus being anointed by a woman with a costly jar of perfume. Matthew and Mark relate the same event, but do not give the woman's name. Luke tells of a different woman, also anonymous, on an earlier occasion. And in yet another event, the woman is identified in John as Mary of Bethany, sister to Martha and Lazarus. To understand the significance of Jesus being anointed on these three occasions, we'll look at each account separately and then compare and contrast them in conclusion. The anointing of Jesus in Matthew takes place just 2 days before Passover in the town of Bethany at Simon the leper's home. Now, when Jesus was at Bethany in the house of Simon the leper, a woman came up to him with an alabaster flask of very expensive ointment, and she poured it on his head as he reclined at the table. Matthew focuses on the anointing of Jesus as a teaching episode for the disciples, who react with anger because of the woman's wasteful extravagance. But Jesus defends her, saying, "She has done a beautiful thing to me." Christ explains that the anointing is to prepare his body for burial, and that the woman's act of love will forever be remembered wherever the good news is preached. Mark tells the same story in similar terms with an anonymous woman with an alabaster box interrupting a meal in Simon the leper's home to anoint the head of Jesus with expensive perfume. Again, the woman's critics described her gift as excessive, complaining that it could have been sold for more than a year's wages. But Jesus receives the woman's gift as a selfless act of love and devotion, an appropriate way to honor the Messiah. Jesus reveals that he will not be with them much longer, which references his impending death and burial. Both Matthew and Mark's account emphasize the prophetic significance of anointing of Jesus, alluding to his death and burial. There may also be an implication of Jesus' kingship, since in the Old Testament, the anointing of the head was often associated with the dedication of kings. In Luke's account of similar yet different instance, Jesus uses the occasion of being anointed to tell a parable about forgiveness. About a year before his death, Jesus was dining in the home of Simon the Pharisee, who had arrogantly neglected to extend the customary respect and hospitality to his guest. While a sinful woman anoints Jesus' feet, lavishing her love and gratefulness upon Jesus. In John's Gospel, Lazarus' sister Mary is the woman who anoints Jesus with a high-priced perfume at a dinner in Bethany. The story is similar in those other Gospels, although this anointing takes place 6 days before Passover. And Judas is the one named as the disciple who objects to the waste that was put on Jesus. On this occasion, Mary took a 12-ounce jar of expensive perfume made from the essence of nard, and she anointed Jesus' feet with it and wiping it with her hair. Jesus defends Mary from Judas' criticism by pointing out the unique opportunity Mary had. "You will always have the poor among you, but you will not always have me." Mary's anointing again points to Jesus' identity as Messiah King, but it also points to his humble position as servant king. When Mary anoints Jesus' feet and then wipes them with her hair, She foreshadows Jesus' actions at the upcoming Last Supper when the Lord washes the disciples' feet and teaches them how to love one another through sacrificial, humble service. In each account, a woman pours out a precious and costly perfume in an extravagant act of worship. The three women who anointed Jesus recognize Christ's unequivocal value and express their gratitude with undeserved love and devotion. Two anointings of Jesus happened during the week of Passover and are linked with his imminent death and burial. The earlier anointing, in Luke's account, is in the middle of Jesus' ministry in Galilee and draws a different lesson on love and forgiveness. In each case, the woman's actions signal more than she knows, but although she may not fully comprehend the messianic significance of her anointing, each woman had come to appreciate Christ's worth more than anyone else at the table. Jesus Christ is God's anointed Messiah. The word Messiah simply means anointed one. On three separate occasions, Jesus is anointed with fragrant ointment in his work as the Savior, the King of Heaven, who was in preparation to die to save his people. All of the events that led up to Jesus' death were significant in some way, shape, or form or another. But this one is extra special because this was Jesus preparing himself to be the propitiation for our sins, to be our substitute, to be the Savior of the world. I hope you were blessed by tonight's discussion. Stay tuned for the rest of the Holy Week experience that will take place on tomorrow.